We've been led to believe that we have to take modern precautions to prevent certain illnesses and diseases, spraying everything with Lysol, sanitizing our hands with Purell, drenching the floor with bleach, inhaling cleaning chemicals half the day. Why would that be necessary if our body has its own built-in immune system? Many organs, cells, tissues working together to rid our body of invaders. It's because our modern world we live in has been engineered to make us sick so our immune system doesn't even work anymore. Diet, lifestyle, radiation. The only scenario you should need an outside factor is if the modern constituent is too extreme for the body to naturally heal, such as physical injury from a severe accident. I mean, the only reason we shouldn't need doctors is for emergency services. Most people do understand what our immune system does. Gets rid of the bad guys so we don't get sick. The lymphatic system is the system of vessels, cells, and organs that carry excess fluids to the bloodstream, as well as filter those bad guys from the blood. But it's so closely associated with the immune system that the two are basically indistinguishable. When someone's referring to the immune system, they're essentially referring to the lymphatic system. So, as we said, the major function of the lymphatic system is to drain the body fluid and return it to the bloodstream. So, the blood pressure in our bodies results in blood leaking from capillaries into various auxiliary tissues. Most of that is reabsorbed directly by those blood vessels, but about 10% of it is drained by the lymphatic system and emptied back into the bloodstream. And 10% of that is about a gallon, so it is quite a bit. This network of lymphatic vessels is a convenient way for transporting the cells of the immune system, as well as transport of macronutrient and micronutrient nutrition, whether that be fat-soluble vitamins or ketones. One reason exercise is so important in sick people is because the lymph is not pumped by the heart. Lymph is that excess fluid which is clear, filled with white blood cells, and it's forced through these vessels by the movements of the body, contraction of the muscles, and breathing. So, if you don't feel too good, even just by jumping up and down, it's why a lot of people go for a run in the morning, really get the blood flowing. They don't mean to get the blood flowing because your heart pumps blood. What those people are doing by running is stimulating their immune system, their lymphatic system. The immune system can be organized into three phases based on timing. One is barrier defenses, such as the skin, mucous membranes. Two is innate immune response, specialized cells. And three is active immune response, involving more cells, especially white blood cells. The cells involved in these processes can be divided into three classes: phagocytic cells, which consume pathogens to destroy them, lymphocytes, which coordinate activities of adaptive immunity, and cells containing cytoplasmic granules, which help mediate immune responses against parasites and intracellular pathogens like VIRU. You know how to spell the rest of that word. Lymphocytes are the primary cells of adaptive immune response, two types being B cells and T cells. B cells produce antibodies, which are proteins that bind specifically to pathogen-associated molecules, the bad guys. T cells do not secrete antibodies, but perform a variety of functions in adaptive immune response. Plasma cells are B cells that change in response to binding to pathogens, secreting antibodies specific to that pathogen. Natural killer cells are a fourth type of lymphocyte that contain cytotoxic granules, which can be used to destroy infected cells. And this lymphoblast, which comes from the lymphoid stem cell, comes from a type of cell made by the bone marrow. Bone marrow being the largest immune system organ, along with the thymus and spleen. The bone marrow is where, as we said, these cells are produced. The T cells mature specifically in the thymus, and the spleen stores all of these various immune cells and also breaks down red blood cells as well as platelets. You also have the tonsils and adenoids, which can stop germs from entering through the mouth or nose. They contain a lot of white blood cells and the hundreds of lymph nodes located throughout the body. All of these dots I put here are where the immune system cells trap germs and activate antibodies. These are connected with lymphatic vessels, you know, the largest one being the thoracic duct. You know, sometimes, you know, when you go to a doctor's office when you're a kid, they feel your neck or they see that, you know, your lymph nodes are inflamed. That's a sign that your body is responding to the infection. And the appendix, to my understanding, can store beneficial bacteria as well as past allergens, so the body recognizes what we should and shouldn't be consuming. And there's also what's called Peyer's patches inside the small intestine, which are small masses of lymphatic tissue. You know, it's almost like the function of these organs is kept a mystery and that they don't want people to know that your body has all of these built-in defenses. You know, it's very common to have your appendix removed. They say your spleen isn't necessary. As far as doctors are concerned, they'll take out all of your organs and then prescribe you medication for the rest of your life. Simply by understanding what organs occur in the body and what they do, you can develop, you know, the most in-depth understanding of health that you would ever need to, because you realize that what makes you healthy is optimal function of all of these organs. You know, in my case, with having iron overload in the liver, you know, it almost killed me. Then you have to figure out, okay, I know these organs do XYZ function. How can I optimize them through diet and lifestyle? And the diet's a bit tricky. You know, it's obviously the main focus of my channel from the vitamin mineral perspective. What do you have to balance? What are you missing? What should the macronutrient ratios be? And then from the lifestyle perspective, you know, you definitely want to reduce Wi-Fi EMF radiation. You want to exercise. You want to get plenty of sun. And just make sure that you remove as many negatives from your lifestyle as possible. You know, the organ glandulars that we have on organ supplements, we do have a combination of thymus and lymph nodes. We do have some spleen in the full spectrum organ supplements. And by all means, you can consume, you know, bone marrow. It's not really something that you can get in supplemental form because it's a higher volume thing. You know, when you have these smaller glands like the thymus, like the spleen, like the lymph nodes, you know, they're small, so they're very, very concentrated with these bioactive properties. Whereas something like the bone marrow is gigantic. It's a lot of marrow. You know, you have to realistically get the food itself and consume it. You know, same thing with liver, same thing with heart, same thing with kidney. You have to consume an awful lot of a supplement or powder compared to, you know, having a portion of the actual food. So thank you guys for joining me today. I think if someone had the intelligence to understand this, they would have already had the intelligence to realize that everything going on was a bunch of nonsense, but we'll see. Let me know what you guys think. If you could please drop a like on the video, leave a comment down below. Subscribe so that YouTube can unsubscribe you next week, and make sure to hit that notification bell so they don't notify you of my videos. Therefore, go to frank-defano.com, definitely sign up for the newsletter, and I will see you guys for tomorrow's video.